Hey everyone, just wanted to share some exciting news. The second DLC for Remnant 2 is finally here. As a huge fan of the game, I dove right in as soon as it dropped. There's something truly captivating about both Remnant 1 and 2 that keeps pulling me back in. They're just that good. So, without any delay, let's dive into the Forgotten Kingdom and see what thrilling challenges awaits us this time around.
Here they come.
Remnant. Shit, shit, shit.
Epoxyltech. Fascinating. Is it trying to talk to me? Another fever dream, perhaps? Or is it? For simplicity's sake, I will choose to believe that. If it will excuse me, I have important work to do. Yes, thanks, and goodbye. Hello again. Persistent. I actually admire that quality a great deal. It is underrated, in my opinion. Well, fever dream or no, if the Epoxyltech is going to be hanging around, I suppose I should tell it my name. I am Rothinder Ahimold. Hello. Oh, it is struggling. Poor thing. The Epoxyltech dream creature may do as it pleases. Walt has more important things to consider. A pleasant chat. Surprisingly so. Indeed. Thanks and goodbye. It cannot be helped, can it? The curiosity! It is killing the Epoxyltech as surely as it is killing me! Knowledge is the only cure. This mural here, on the cave wall, can it comprehend the meaning? A trick question, of course. I have dedicated my life to learning so that I may find the answers I seek and put the pieces together. After years and years of what it asks. Proof of all that matters in the whole world. Proof that the lost tribe of the Pan does exist. See, I have found the location of their civilization. It is no less than miraculous. I have gotten ahead of myself, have I not? I do apologize. My manners are not what they once were. I have been alone a long while now. Very long while. What brings the Epoxyltech here? How can Walt be of service? If it is looking to spend, I have a few valuable items I may be willing to part ways with. Funding for my research must be procured by whatever means necessary. It is as good a time as any to stock up. Destroy them. No, that cannot be true. Yes. Goodbye. My long search. This is it.
Let's go.
That's over. Great, more bad news.
Thank you. Glad that's over.
Truly wondrous! Hello! It is nice to see a familiar face around these parts. Even if it is a strange and hornless one. It has arrived at an opportune time. See, I have found another mural. This one is more than I could have ever dreamed of. This discovery is downright exhilarating! The implications, the possibilities, it's overwhelming in the best of ways. Excuse me, I have a tendency to get carried away. Is my Paxoltec friend in need of something? What is intriguing the Paxoltec, I wonder? Listen well. Thelos survived the plague that had long haunted the Pan. After falling ill, he began hearing an unusual sound that seemed to come from the ground itself. Music. Strange music, with no instruments or voice to carry it. He ventured out to find the source. What he found was her. Lydusa, a goddess of stone. In exchange for a year of companionship away from his people, she promised to cure him and give him the means to cure the others. He agreed. Oh, a very long time indeed, especially amid such uncertain times. In his time away, the plague had ravaged his tribe. But he was able to save those who remained and start over anew. The goddess had granted him an unusually long life, and he ruled over the Pan for several prosperous centuries. The Pan worshipped their new goddess, building a temple and singing her praises. Here is the exciting part. It is said that she grew fond of the Pan and actually taught them how to use her power over the living stones. When the ancient Pan left their homeland to escape the plague, several ships were separated from the rest and landed here. Thelos was their leader and helped build a new society, but he soon fell ill with that same plague. Walt is right here. Together we will unravel the mysteries of the Lost Tribe. Do not doubt it for a moment. It must listen well, yes? When the ancient Pan left their homeland to escape the Thelos was their leader. And help what else, my friend? As it were, I have some incredible items that I would be willing to part with. The support means a lot, my friend. So soon? Well, If it must go, it must go.
This looks important. enemies. Era. Os. Os. Zayat. Huzo. Nas of. Nas Handul. Escuera. Steadfast Lydusa, spirit of the land, nymph of the glittering grotto. When the ground beneath you shakes and quakes and tosses you fro, when boulders tumble and crush from above, when the deep dark caves twist and lead you astray, that's Lydusa's wrath. Now speak, before I petrify your flesh to never-moving stone. Why do you trespass here? Exploration is thin-veiled shelter for intrusion. You wish to steal from me, like all the other wicked beasts. But beasts won't take anything from Lydusa, not anymore. For what's most precious to me has already been taken. The wicked beasts, the hooved ones, they stole Lydusa's precious thing. Without it, I can't tell my singing stones to cease their song of wrath. Yes, the singing stones belong to Lydusa. Once they sang only sweetly. It was my magic that first sung them to life. A song to make them twirl and dance like wind-caught sand. But the wicked beasts twisted my sweet song to screams. I screamed and screamed. Now, poor Lydusa has lost something precious. The beasts stole it and locked it away. I can't sing without it. You, hoofless beast, will find my precious thing and return it to me. Do you feel the stone flesh within? Turning your inside cold and still. That is my curse. The touch of Lydusa. And I won't pay. I don't remember. But it was precious to me. And it was sundered. Stolen. Without it, I am shatter split. I am not me. I am not Lydusa. When you find it, beast, you will know that it's mine. That it is precious. Now go, before you become petrified and useless. Yes, leave. You must find what was stolen and bring it here.
Done.
Sometimes one must do what must be done. They had no choice. Oh, forgive me, my friend. I have a lot on my mind. I found another piece of the story, and I am another step closer to the truth. It is tragic. Bloody. A betrayal, some might say. But they would be wrong. That is just the way of things. Trust me. I know all too well. Anyway, does the Puxeltech need something? I have new items on offer. Yes? What is it wanting? A priesthood was formed in service to the goddess. And she taught them alone to wield the power of the living stones. The simple things only, from what I can gather. Heating pots on command, lulling young ones to sleep and things of the like. But there was so much more potential. This divine power was right at their fingertips, but she selfishly kept it to herself. It must have been maddening. They made a plan to trap her. One day a year, she took mortal form and required Thalos to lie with her. Our noble king was dubbed the Bloodless King because he never sired a child. It was because of her. He was under her spell. She was less powerful in her mortal form. So when that night came around, they used their own ancient magics and captured her. Thalos was enraged and fought back, killing his own kind. Yeah, they had no choice but to capture him as well. Thalos was driven mad by the goddess. He would not listen to reason. So they imprisoned him and took control of the kingdom. Knowing the goddess was fond of her royal pet, they bartered his life in exchange for the secrets of her power. They got what they wanted, what they needed to safeguard their society. Using her power, they were able to create living constructs to do their bidding. And so, the Pan went from living like savages to an era of swift advancement. Imagine having such power in the palm of one's hand. Power like that could change the fate of our people. Even those deemed unworthy of the Thane Fruit. It is tragic. But that is the way of history. Of the world. One must rise from tragedy. Stronger than before. The secret of this power must still be around here somewhere. I can feel it. Trust me, my friend. This day will live on in the annals of history forever and ever. If it is in need of assistance, look no further than Walt. I hope I have something of use for its journey. I hope my friend's journey is fruitful.
All right, let's do this. status isn't looking good.
That's it. For now.
Is that a pooch? Come here, come on, come on, boy. Oh, God, it's been ages since I saw one. Man's best friend, right there. Wait, what the? Well, I'll be damned. Either you're a human, or I ate some bad mushrooms. I haven't seen a fellow Earthling in decades. All right, explain yourself, or I start shooting. I'm asking the questions around here, kid. Where did you come from? And what are you doing in my home base? Talk. And if I like what you say, you may just walk out of here alive. So get talking. And you are from Earth. I knew it. wonders never cease. At ease. I'm Private Jack Driver. Now, this is gonna sound crazy, but I've been stranded here on Yesha for over a century. I may be an old man now, but I was actually a kid when I first came here. New recruit. Fresh out of boot camp. Life has been trying, to say the least. I would be dead if not for my survival training. Hell, you throw me for a loop here. I feel like I'm dreaming, but... Well, those types of dreams usually involve go-go boots. Mr. Sandman has lost his touch if I'm asleep. Get in line, kid. The white in my gruff and my horrible back pain tell me I've been waiting a lot longer for answers than you have. I'll go first. Wasn't a question, but glad you're making it easier on yourself. Now tell me, is America still safe? Still free? Did we beat the Ruskies to the moon? Are there flying cars or anything like that? Come on, lay it on me. I don't know what to say. Yeah. Thanks for telling me the truth, I guess. Deal's a deal. What are your questions? Well, this ain't story hour, so I'll try to keep it brief. When I was a new recruit, I was sent here on a recon mission with my squad. We were captured by the Pan. Thanks to our captain, we managed to escape, but we were separated. We never saw our commanding officer again. He must have died and stayed dead. But the rest of us, well, we died and then somehow reappeared at the stone we used to travel here from Earth. We were the same, but older. Bizarre, I know. Long story short, the stone stopped working, so we were trapped here on Yesha for good. We would have died if not for our training and the things our captain had taught us about this world. Damned if I know. We were soldiers, not scientists. I bet Captain Ford could have figured it out, but like I said, we'd already lost him. I'd have done anything to fix that thing, but no dice. We were stranded in this hellhole. Over time, the rest of my squad died one too many times and never showed up again. Eventually, you age out of that trick, I guess. Hey, I'm no spring chicken, so I'm likely on my last leg myself. That isn't funny. Don't you dare sully the memory of our dearly departed commanding officer. He was the greatest man I've ever known, aside from my pops. He deserves better than that. I never told you his first name. Holy smoke. Today just keeps getting weirder and weirder. Well, hell. We thought he was dead. So I bet he assumed the same. That or he escaped, but then couldn't get back through that broken stone. I know he would have come back for us if he could have. I can't believe he's still alive. If I ever reunite with that brave bastard, I'm gonna punch him right in the kisser and then give him the biggest hug he's ever had. One last thing before we part ways. Tell it to me straight. Do you know of a way to get back home? Now, I'm not big on asking for favors. I've been in survival mode the vast majority of my life. But I'm asking you this. When you go back, will you take me with you? Words can't express what I'm feeling right now. Thank you. In fact, here, take this. A little token of my appreciation. It's not much, but it's saved my hide more times than I can count. Won't be needing it anymore, so I want you to have it. Now, go and do whatever it is you came here to do. I'd go with, but truth be told, I'm a rickety old man now. I'd only slow you down. Finish your mission, and come back. I'll be waiting.
Okay. This is it.